that slight dip yesterday. Moving on now to our company call, we are joined by the president and CEO of Philippine 7, the operator of the 7-Eleven franchise here in the Philippines, Mr. Victor Paterno. Good morning.
Good morning, Warren.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
All right, let's get right into it. Let's talk about first your nine-month financial results. Sales, a very good 32% growth year-on-year. Profits, about the same growth margin. But taking a look at the third quarter, your sales a little bit slower, but still very impressive, 25% growth year-on-year. What contributed to that slight dip?
Well, as you remember, we had the Habagat in August, so that was a big hit to sales. We're very weather sensitive, no? So along with my daily sales increase per store, I track the amount of rainfall versus last year. That's how sensitive we are. 40% of what we sell is beverage, so it's very weather sensitive. So the Habagat totally negative growth for that month. The other event was this expansion into Cebu. When we expanded into Cebu, we had to build up a lot of logistics infrastructure, which when you only have 16 stores and you have a warehouse built for 100, the costs are going to weigh down on you. So that we took that hit in the third quarter too.
Yeah. Well, I imagine you plan on correcting that as soon as possible. You do have an expansion plan. You're aiming to get 1,200 stores up across the country. I believe that's your current capacity for your storage.
Well, yeah, for logistics. And we hope to, we will have 1,000 stores before the end of next year.
So the rapid expansion.
Rapid expansion model.
Yeah. Right now, how many stores do you have exactly?
816.
So getting pretty close to that. I understand you have a partnership with Chevron, which is also going to help you meet your expansion target.
Yes, that's right. We started with 25 stores. This year, we're adding 25 more. Mm-hmm. Next year, we'll add another 50. So that's been very good. Because the stores are there already.
Yeah.
They already have dealers who are also franchisees, so they're there already also. So it makes a lot of sense for both sides.
Well, it's a pretty basic business setup. You have the gas station and you put a convenience store right next to it.
That's right.
It works. I want to talk a little bit about the franchising, though. We were talking about this earlier off cam, that there's a strong demand for your franchises right now. Why do you think that's so? Why do you think people are trying to get into the convenience store business right now?
Well, I think when they see growth, it attracts interest. And I think you have low, since the rates at the bank are so low, people are looking for businesses. Mm-hmm. It was interesting when we went into Cebu. Before we went in, we looked for franchisees. And we couldn't scare up any interest. Then when you opened the first store and people saw the lines outside, all of a sudden a flood of applications came in. So
right.
I think that's the way it goes.
So they're encouraged. Also, it also helps to have a very recognizable brand in 7-Eleven. Of course, you are a retailer, and there's been so much talk about consumer demand being so strong this year, helping to drive growth, particularly in the third quarter, 7.1% growth in GDP. You said it yourself, you even had the weather problem in Habagat in the third quarter, and you still grew 25% sales. Do you think the demand will be strong enough to sustain this level of growth all the way until next year?
Yes, I think so. I think investors are certainly betting on that to happen, if you look at the prices in the market now, including ours. We do believe next year will be even stronger. Again, the one thing we cannot predict with very little certainty is the weather. But barring that, no, you have elections next year, the economy, everything looks all set to grow next year. Confidence is very high. Mm-hmm. I think so.
Okay, last topic I wanted to talk to you about is the introduction of new foreign investors into the company, Philippine 7. The news broke actually in September. There was at least one group already identified, but you did say that there are several people coming in. Tell us a bit about how this is going to affect your ownership structure, what they're going to bring to the table for Philippine 7.
Well, basically you had some of the founding shareholders selling a bit of their, or in some cases selling down a significant amount. Again, at these valuations, makes you think twice. And their positions were taken over by foreign funds. the most, the largest, and the reported one is Arisaig, Arisaig Partners, which holds almost 11%. And they are, at these valuations, the only people who really have the confidence to make bets of that size are specialist funds. So these guys are almost always consumer-focused funds. And they're also very long-term funds. They look at windows of 10 years. And again, when you're looking at multiples this high, you drive out all the generalist punters. So almost everyone is, except for a couple, are specialized consumer long-only funds. And they are, well, basically the story is simple. They say, well, if the Philippines is the next Thailand, as many are hoping, then maybe you'll be the next 7-Eleven Thailand. 7-Eleven Thailand has 6,000 stores, $12 billion market cap. So that's they're betting on that to happen.
Yeah, so very impressive figures there. And if they're betting long-term 10 years, it looks like they're very bullish indeed. Thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you.
It's good to have you on the show.
Thank you, Warren.
Mr. Victor Paterno, President and CEO of Philippine 7 Corporation. And taking a look at 7 shares right now, they're trading also in the green, along with much of the rest of the market, up 0.6% right now at 80 pesos and 50 cents.